Hey everyone, welcome to a new episode of the Multiplayer RTS series. Today we will continue where we left off from part 1. In this episode I will make sure that we can at least get some movement working in the game and also spawning our unit. If you want to follow along with this series and have not started yet, check out the card that displays at the top right now to check out the playlist. So what we will do first is to make our own script like I did in my other video when I added multiplayer movement to a first person game. We just want our own script so that we can add our own code to the network manager code by inheriting it. Inside the scripts folder, create a new folder called networking as we will add all our networking code in here. After creating the folder, create a new script called my network manager and go into the My Network Manager script. Once the My Network Manager script is open, then change mono behavior to Network Manager to inherit from the Mirror Network Manager and press Control and period to select using Mirror. Save the script and head back into Unity. Once we are in Unity, we can then remove Network Manager HUD first, as it is dependent on Network Manager, and then Network Manager second. Drag and drop the My Network Manager script inside of the Network Manager and add Network Manager HUD again. Take the player prefab we have and drag and drop that into player prefab game object and change player spawn method to round robin as what it was. Click the three dots on the right of the script and move it up to have it at the top. We can then put both spawn points in one new empty game object and call it spawn positions. We will just leave the game with two spawn points for now and increase a bit later to test more than two players. Then create a new 3D plane object where the player can walk on and call it ground. If you already have a terrain or a scene built, then that is perfect. Now that we have a ground object, now we will need to generate the nav mesh by going to Window, AI, Navigation, and then make sure the terrain you want the nav mesh to generate on has navigation static enabled and the navigation area is walkable. Select Bake, and you could always change the agent radius if you want units to go closer to buildings that are marked as not walkable areas. And when you're happy with the settings, then click on Bake and then the nav mesh will be generated. Now that we have the nav mesh up and running, now we want to add a movement script onto the player prefab, which we are going to rename to Unit, as the player that gets spawned represents a unit. First, let's create a new folder inside of the scripts folder and call it units, and then create a new C# script called unit movement. Double click the unit prefab to open it from the prefabs folder and then add the nav mesh agent component. Make sure to play around with the settings like the radius of obstacle avoidance and your other settings. We can then also add the network transport component for the sync of the movement of units. Let's add the unit movement script as well and open it up. Once the script is open, then we want to change the inheritance from mono behavior to network behavior and press Control and period and select using mirror. Remove the start method and make the update method be private void update. And let this only be a client callback and not something that the server needs to update. We want to pull through the nav mesh agents, so we will say serialize field private nav mesh agent and call it agent, which equals to null. At this moment, you will see it underlined in red. Press Control and period on top of the nav mesh agent and select using unityengine.ai. Then we also want to cache the camera and create a variable of private camera and call it main camera. Let us create two regions, the region server and in region, and region client with the update method inside of it, and then end region. In the client region, we will create a public override on start authority and select it, and it will be public override void on start authority. And inside, we will replace base.onStartAuthority to cache in main camera to be equal to camera.main. In the server part, we will create a command that gets sent from the client to the server to execute this command after validation. So in square brackets, we will say command, and then private void command move vector 3 position, as we want to move the unit at this point. So first we will check if the position that we clicked on sends back an invalid value and make sure we don't go further then. So if the nav mesh isn't dot sample position and give the position without nav mesh hit result and call it hit, the max distance being 1f and area mask being nav mesh dot all areas. And if that is correct, then return. If sample position gives a value correctly, then agent.setDestination hit.position will run. In the update method from the client callback, we first want to see if we have authority as the client to use the update method. So we will make a if statement of if we don't have authority, then return. If we do have authority, then we want to register if we have pressed any button. In an RTS game for movement, you will need to have the unit selected and also right click on the area you wish for the unit to move. So we will check if the right mouse button wasn't pressed, then return. We have also installed the input system package, and this gives extra features that would always be beneficial in the future. So we will type in if isn't mouse and then control plus period and select using input system, then dot current dot right button dot was pressed this frame, then return. If you have authority and you have pressed the right mouse button, then we want to create a ray called ray and make it equal to the main camera dot screen point to ray and pass in mouse dot current dot position dot read value, where read value returns a vector 2 to be used. Now that we have a ray, we need to check if that ray actually hits something and does not go into infinity, and for this we write if isn't physics.raycast and pass in ray out raycast hit and call it hit mathf.infinity, then return. Once we are happy with having authority and making sure we press the right mouse button and also getting the ray value and checking if it doesn't go off into infinity, then we can pass in the hit.point value with the command move hit.point. When we go back into Unity after saving the script, we can then just drag and drop the unit with its nav mesh agent into the serialized field agent. Now that we have the basic movements of the character, where we will still add some animators and give them more life with idling and running in a future episode, we just want to get spawning more of them implemented in this episode as well. Create an empty game object and call it player, and also add the network identity component which will represent the player. It does not have to be a visual representation, just the fact that you are the player, as the unit can't represent a player as it has a different function. Drag the player game object under prefabs and then create another empty game object and call it unit spawner and make it a prefab. This will refer to the base and what we click on to spawn in units. Delete the two prefabs you just created on the scene. You then want to open the unit spawner prefab and drag in your model that you want to click on as the base building for it to spawn units, or you can just create a cube. In my case, I will use Knight's Tent 01 and adjust its scale down to 0.2. Make sure that the pivot point is underneath the base, as this will spawn on the ground at the unit spawner position. The dragged in asset should not have a box collider, and any collider should be on the parent game object. So we will add the box collider on top of the parent game object and size it accordingly. When you are happy with the box collider around your base building, then we want to have another empty game object and call it unit spawn point. This can be customized to spawn at random positions, as you just make units appear out of thin air. So if you would like your units to run from the building to the position, then this can be done like this as well. But for now, we will add a unit spawn point and just place it at 5 on the X. So at this current moment, we won't do any selecting of buildings or units. We will just make it possible that you click on the base Then it will spawn units and also be seen across the network. Create a new script and call it unit spawner and attach the script to the unit spawner game object. Then add the component network identity for the same reason the unit has it and open up the created script. When you have the script open, then we want to change mono behavior to network behavior and press control and period and select using mirror. We are not done at the top, as we will also add iPointer click handler, as we need the event system to trigger each time we click on the building. Make sure to press control and period to choose using event systems. Remove the start and update method. We will add them when we need them. Separate the server and client code in this one script, so we will just make two regions to keep the code organized. Under the client code, we want to know when we click on the building, then it needs to spawn a unit. So first we will call the interface method from the click handler, and it's called public void on pointer click pointer event data event data. You can also just press control and period on the iPointer click handler, and it will ask you if you want to generate the interface. Inside of the method, we will say if event data dot button isn't equal to pointer event data dot input button dot left, then return, just to make sure that the left click spawns the unit and right click moves it. We will be using the left click button to select the building and units in the future episodes. We also want to make sure that we are clicking on our own building, so we can check this by saying if we don't have authority, then return. Now that we know we have left clicked on the building and that we own it, now we want to run a command on the server to show other clients that I've spawned a unit and spawn one for myself. Let's go to the top to reference the unit prefab and where the unit will spawn by doing a serialized field private game object unit prefab equal null and serialized field private transform unit spawn point equal null. Inside of Unity, we can then drag into the script the unit prefab we want to be spawned and also add in the spawn point for where they will be appearing. Back in the code under the server region, we will now make the command of private void of command spawn unit. Now here we want to instantiate the unit, and instantiate just requires three variables. It requires the prefab and the position it needs to be instantiated at and the rotation it should be in. So we will state game object of unit spawn equal instantiate unit prefab unit spawn point dot position and unit spawn point dot rotation. We will make it possible to position the spawn point in a later video where the units will march towards after spawning. Now that we can spawn the unit, this unit won't show to other clients, as you will need to say who this instantiated object belongs to and if it is spawned for other players. To do this, mirror has the method called spawn, and to call this we just say network server.spawn and give the unit spawn for which game object needs to be spawned for other players, and then by giving authority to the client this was spawned from, we can just say connection to client. Seeing that this script is attached to your unit spawner, the connection to client will see you as the owner of the unit as well. Now that the method can create your spawned unit, the only thing we want to do is to go back to the client code and call the command after checking for authority to spawn at your building with command spawn unit. Save the code and go into Unity. We now have to add the unit spawner to be spawned when a new player is added in the game. So for this, we can go to our My Network Manager script and open it up. And at the top, we want to add the prefab we would like to have spawned when a player is added by saying serialized field private game object unit spawner prefab equal null. We will add the prefab in a section, but for now we will create a new public override method called onServerAddPlayer, which has network connection of the con, which is the connection that just happened when a player was added. In your method, you will need to have the base.onServerAddPlayer of the con. And this is just when a player is added. But we want to instantiate the prefab of the spawner right after the connection. So after the base, we just state that the game object called unit spawner instance is equal to instantiate unit spawner prefab and we want to spawn this at the player spawn point, as the player still gets assigned a position with round robin in the network manager. We then say the con.identity.transform.position, which translates just as the player position, and then the same for the rotation transform, which will be con.identity.transform.rotation. And just like the unit spawner with the server command, we want to make sure that everyone sees the prefab that was spawned. So right after the unit spawner has been instantiated, then we want to say networkserver.spawn, which is the unit spawner instance that was instantiated, and con gets the authority of it. Let's just remove the start and update method as we are not using them, and save the code and go back into Unity. In the network manager, we want to make sure that we have the player game object under the player prefab, and then click on the plus icon by registered spawnable prefabs and drag in the unit spawner prefab and click it again and add the unit prefab. Now Mirror will know what prefabs are registered to be spawned. Then we also want to bring the unit spawner prefab in the serialized field of unit spawner prefab we created a second ago in the script to reference what we want to spawn. So because pointer click uses event data, we need to just create a canvas in the scene, as we will need one in the future for the UI, by going to create UI canvas. Once it has been created, then you will see that the event system game object has been created with the canvas. Click on the event system and you will see by the standalone input module component that it has a red error which says you can replace the old input with the new input system package. Click replace and then it has the new input system with more functionality. For the detection of where we click, we can go to the main camera and add the physics raycaster component. If we build and run the game now, then we will see that both players now have a building spawned at each of the spawn points, and if you click on your building, then it will spawn units at the spawn position. If you click multiple times, then it will spawn them at the same position multiple times, and once you right click, you will see them all moving around. You can't click on the other player's base and spawn units, as you don't have authority, and the client can spawn their own units as well and move their own units. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, make sure to like and subscribe. Comment down below if you like the content I'm releasing to increase that YouTube algorithm goodness. Also, if you want to support the channel, check out my Patreon page and join the Discord channel. Have a look at all the links down below. If you followed along with the code and it's still not working, then make sure to check out the pastebin link down below. Cheers.